Hi friends, welcome back to the new series JavaScript Zero to Hero. In this series, I'm explaining all the basic concepts in JavaScript. In this video, I'm going to talk about variables in JavaScript. What are variables? Variables are containers, also called data containers, to hold data or values. Assume you have two baskets, a fruit basket and a vegetable basket. You are taking an apple and putting it into the fruit basket, and you are taking some tomatoes and putting it in vegetable basket. Similarly, in JavaScript, we can create named containers and store values. We can create a variable using the var keyword. In ES6, we can also use let and const to create variables. I am going to explain the difference between var, let, and const in a separate video. Also, I want to cover the ES6 concepts separately. For now, you just understand there are different ways in which we can create a variable. So after the var keyword, we need to give a name for the variable. Let me give it as my number. This part is called variable declaration. That means we are instructing JavaScript that we have created a variable named my number. So JavaScript will create a named space to store our value. Now we can assign some value using the equal to sign, like this. This part is called variable assignment. Here we are instructing JavaScript to store this value in that namespace. So now I can use this variable inside my program. So if I put that inside an alert, I can see the number instead of the variable name. There are certain rules we need to follow to name a variable. First of all, JavaScript is case sensitive. I have declared the variable name as my number with small m. If I try to use capital M anywhere after that, it will throw error saying this variable is not defined. And one more thing we need to note here is, we can create variables either in uppercase or in lowercase or using both. But the best practice is to use lowercase for variables, and if there are multiple words, it is suggested to use camel case. We can use numbers in variable name, but it is not allowed to use number as the first character. It will throw error. Special characters are not allowed in variable names, except dollar sign and underscore. We can use these two as the first character. Some people use underscore to separate the words like this. This is called snake case. This is allowed, but it is not recommended in JavaScript because it is considered as bad practice. But in languages like Python, this is recommended. And finally, keywords are not allowed. Keywords are predefined set of words JavaScript uses. Example, var is a keyword, alert is also a keyword, and we have more. So we cannot create a variable name like var alert equal to 5. Because JavaScript cannot differentiate whether it is a variable or a predefined function. So we get error. And in JavaScript, we call each line as a statement. After every statement, it is recommended to use a semicolon. It is not mandatory to put semicolon when you put each statement in each line, but it is recommended. You can also declare all variables in a single line. In that case, semicolon is mandatory. Otherwise, it won't work. In fruit basket, we can take the apple out and we can put orange inside. Similarly, in JavaScript, we can reassign a variable with a different value. So if I refresh, we can see the new value is showing up. One thing to note here is, when we reassign, we are not using the var keyword. We use it only when we declare first time. Also, we have already seen, when we try to use a variable which is not declared, we get the error, the variable is not defined. But what will happen if we try to use a variable which is not assigned any value? In that case, JavaScript will assign a value called undefined. So if I refresh, we can see this. That's all about variables. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.